All right. Ref sending it up. Northeast takes tip. Miss communication right off the bat. Turnover for Northeast, and Quakerdale now has the ball.
Not what you want to see coming out of the tip off for your Hawks.
Definitely not. Quakerdale now to inbound. Dylan Phillips with the ball. Dribbling right now with the shot. Emmett Page with the rebound. By Kawaso, takes it in, goes for the layup, and he gets it off the kind of wild shot.
Nice shot there by Moses, getting the ball up the court and taking it coast to coast for the easy two buckets.
Now with the ball, Mike Barker. Back to Dylan Phillips. Dylan Phillips takes it in, step back two. He gets it to fall, score now 2-2. Emmett Page gets to Joely Feely up top by Kawaso with the shot. And that's in for Northeast by Kawaso. By Kawaso, two early shots. Now Dylan Phillips. Pass it up to Kevin Polanco. Over to Mike Barker. Mike Barker with the step back. He's off. By Kawaso with the rebound. Taking the ball up the court now. Behind the back crossover. Down low to Joel Ufili. Post move. He's off the front of the rim.
That's one shot Joel would like to have back. It's a very good move for him. That turnaround quick baby hook, he would like that one to fall next time.
Jaquez Harris off with the shot. Here comes Emmett Page over to Seth Cota. Seth Cota step back three, and he gets it to fall. Northeast off to a great start here.
Coming out very good shooting-wise, Seth Cota and Moses Baikwasa, who we talked about in our pregame, really stepping up this game so far.
Now with the ball. Oh, turns it over to it. Daniel Okwe taking the ball up the court over to Baikwasa. Baikwasa pump fake drive over to Joel. And Joel with the baby layup. Timeout early here for Quakerdale. We'll take one as well. You're watching the Hawk Sports Network.
Today, a new creature walks among us, terrorizing innocent citizens. Until this threat can be contained, we must all be on the lookout for the dreaded digital deadwalkers.
Dude!
They're not looking out for you.
Engage!
A public service safety message from the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons, who want to keep everyone well connected with strong, healthy bones.
Welcome back here to the Cox Activity Center. Northeast jumping out to a quick 10-2 lead, 18-01 left here in the first half.
Oh, I was just going to say Northeast has done a very good job of pushing the ball up the court, really taking advantage of the numbers right now on both benches.
By Kawaso gets the pick, takes it down the court for the score. Dylan Phillips with the ball now. On the drive, looking to set up one of his teammates. Kicks it over to Jaquez Harris. Malik Griffin with the ball. And he loses it out of bounds. Northeast now up 12-2. Emmett Page takes court. He gets a screen from Joel. Joel on the roll. Looking to set up his man. Drives in. Kicks out to Malik. Seth Cota with a wide open three. Splashes it.
That's one thing you do not want to leave open when you're on the defensive end is Seth Cota from behind the arc. He will hit it every time.
Dylan Phillips. Eagles swinging it around and they lose it again. Seth Cota now taking the ball up the court, drives it in. Out to Baikwasa. Baikwasa down low to Joel, and Joel gets the easy shot. Northeast knew they had the numbers advantage like coming into this game. And it looks like they're going to keep using it, just keep running the ball down the court, try to tire out this Eagles defense.
Northeast really taking advantage, like I said, of those numbers, really pushing the ball up the court, looking down low, because Northeast now has a size advantage.
Seth Cota gets the easy layup. And looks like we have another timeout. Going to keep it here this time. Northeast coming out shooting early, 19-2. Just having a ton of it so far.
Yeah, they've done really good taking advantage of their speed, their ability to create turnovers, and then to get it down low to the Joel Ufili down there. So I don't want to jinx myself, but Northeast should win this game just by numbers and then the ability to run and not get tired.
Yeah, and they're taking good shots too. They're kind of moving the ball around, passing it very, very fluently, and looking for the best shot every time down the court, which is, as you can see, resulting in a great score. Seth Cota, we mentioned before the game, a great score for this team, and by Kawaso, both 8-7. And then Joel Ufili kind of rounds out that big three. He's got four. And just a great game for Northeast so far.
So far, Northeast is shooting 88% from field goal, and that one miss was Joel's turnaround baby hook that just hit the rim early, and then they're 3-for-3 from three-pointers right now.
Tonight might be one of those nights. We said Northeast kind of is either hot or cold, and so far they're looking hot from three. Haven't missed a shot yet. Phillips with the ball now, taking it down the court. He drives it in, loses it, but the ref's going to call a foul on it, send him to the free throw line. That's going to go against Emmett Page. Phillips with his first free throw shot of the game. He gets it to drop. Northeast now up 19-3, 16-21 left to go in the first half. Phillips goes 2-for-2 from the three-point line. Emmett Page taking the ball at the court. He looks like he's trying to push the pace here.
I'm sure that's one of the keys that Coach Anderson has in store. Get them running right away, make sure they get tired, and then you can work your offenses later on.
Kind of a bad shot by Kawaso. Kind of had an open lane for a layup there, pump faked and took a step back shot instead. And the Eagles capitalize. That's Malik Griffin with the three-point shot. Emmett Page looking to set up the offense here. Gives it to Daniel Quay, over to Seth Cota on the wing, hands it off to Page. Daniel with the screen, Page with the lane, drives it but loses it. Daniel Quay with the rebound, however. Good putback.
These refs are going to let a lot of things go. I'm sure they don't want to call a lot of fouls, put this Quakerdale team into trouble.
Emmett Page with the rebound. Over to Joel Ufili down low and almost with the block for the Quakerdale Eagles is Mike Barker, but they're going to get him with the foul since Joel Ufili to the free throw line here. First free throw for the Hawks tonight.
Joel was really looking for that slam, would have sparked this pretty decent crowd we got here.
Joel off with his first free throw shot. Checking in for Northeast is Junior. Junior Oscar checking out is Emmett Page, and we have Ben Bacuasso. Looks like he'll be checking in for Ufili here, depending if Joel makes the free throw or not. He's off on his second one as well, goes 0-for-2. Barker now taking the ball up the court. Swinging the ball around over to Phillips. Harris in the corner, he's off. Griffin with the rebound. There's a little post work, but Junior Oscar with the block. Daniel Quay now taking the ball up the court, passes it into traffic. Northeast with another turnover. Malik Griffin now with the ball.
That's one thing you can't have, especially when you're playing a team with only six players on their roster active. You cannot have a lot of turnovers.
By Kawaso now on the fast break. Takes it in, gets the easy layup. Now Phillips with the ball. He drives in, kicks it out to Malik Griffin. Malik on the drive, he loses it. Out of bounds, getting a Northeast ball. Now comes in Ben Moxness for Joel Ufili. And Luke Rollman checks in for Daniel Aquay. Junior Oscar taking the ball up the court here. Up to Ben up top. Moses with a three-point shot from deep. It's a pretty good three. Harris now. Pass it up to Phillips. Phillips over to Griffin on the wing. Griffin off of the three-point shot by Kawaso, now pushing the ball up the court. Behind the back crossover, loses it. And looks like Junior Oscar's going to pick up the ball, however. Over to Ben. Ben with the three-point shot, and he gets it to fall. Oh, looks like the ref's going to call it a two. His foot was on the line. Still a good shot for Northeast.
Helps the numbers. Just not the shot that Ben wanted, but he still made it.
Quaker Dale working the ball around there off with another three-pointer. And that's going to go off Ben Moxness. Great hustle play from Kendall Grimes. Checking in from Northeast, we got Zach James. Checking out, we got Seth Cota. By Kawasa trying to get the defense set up here, get everybody ready. And Grimes with the three-point shot. He's one for one. Junior Oscar getting the play from the coach. Moxness with the screen. He rolls off to Luke Rollman. Pass over to Zach James. James on the drive. Kind of low pass. Gets the ball back, however, by Kawaso. Crossover three. He's off. Harris now pushing the ball up the court. Got Polanco in the corner, up to Phillips. He's off. Junior Oscar now quick. Look at the acceleration, misses the layup. That was great acceleration from him. Great rebound from Luke Roman with the Kareem hook.
Quick turnaround jumper, easy two buckets for Roman.
Malik Griffin now looking to set up Ben Moxness. Over to Phillips on the wing. Back to Harris. Harris, three-point shot from deep. He's off by Kawaso with the rebound. Gives it over to Zach James. Down low to Luke Rollman. Luke Rollman gets the and one layup. Great power play from Luke.
That is going to be a big key for Northeast in this game. They have three guys that are as tall, if not taller, than Quaker Dale's big man. They're going to try and get him into foul trouble, take advantage of the block.
Yeah, Quaker Dale's biggest player active tonight is 6'7", Kendall Grimes. Northeast has two players, 6'8", and 6'9". And then Daniel Quay and Ben Moxon's checking at 6'7". So they definitely have the size advantage over this Quaker Dale Eagles team. Nice tip pass from Emmett Page. Flex it out of bounds. Mike Barker passing it in, gives it over to Phillips. Phillips working the offense, gets a screen from Griffin. Drives in and blocked by Junior Oscar. Junior Oscar with two big blocks here early in the game. Looking good defensively.
Northeast has really stepped up their defensive game. As we saw last week, you know, it was a high scoring game. This week they're keeping it kind of low scoring.
Griffin now up top, calling for the screen, driving off it, tries to get the step back three, but Luke Roman's there. And we got Phillips over, and shot clock violation on Quaker Dale. Mike Barker couldn't get the shot off in time. That's a good job from Quaker Dale, though, working the ball around. Just took a little bit too much time on that shot clock. Junior Oscar now working the offense. Over to Luke Roman up top. Swings it to Ben Moxness. Over to James. James over to Page. Back to Moxness. Moxness with the three. And he gets it to fall again. First three-pointer of the night for Ben Moxness.
Puts Northeast at 5 of 6 from three-point range. 83% shooting.
Looking good. Phillips on the drive gets fouled. Looks like that foul is going to go against Junior Oscar for the Northeast Hawks. Phillips so far 2 for 2 on the night as he gets his third one to fall. Second free throw about to come up. He gets that one to go as well. Now Emmett Page looking to go on offense. Page finds an open lane and an easy layup. Defensive breakdown right there for the Eagles.
That was good dribble drive penetration by Emmett Page. Find the open lane, hesitation real quick, put up the easy layup.
Grimes in the drive, step back shot, he's off. Page now pushing the ball up again. Gets the drive in, no foul call, but gets his own rebound. Out to Zach James. Zach James with the three, he's off. Malik Griffin with the rebound. Bad pass off the knees of Grimes. Got Caleb Reinick checking in for the Northeast Hawks. And Kevin Polanco checking in for the Quaker Dale Eagles. Emmett Page with the ball. Luke Rollman on the wing. Moxis up top. Back to Page. Got Luke Rollman down low with a size advantage. Hook shot. He's off. Good swarming defense from the Eagles. Phillips now looking to push. Over to Grimes. Grimes with the shot, and he gets an elbow shot to fall. Page looking to set up the offense here. Gets the screen from Moxness, pulls up from three, and he gets another one to splash. Northeast lighting it up from the three-point line tonight.
Very good shooting just overall from Northeast, shooting 72% from field goal and 71% from the three-point line.
Northeast now up 41-14, 9:56 left to go in the first half. We got Joel Ufili and Daniel LaQuay checking in. And like we said at the beginning of the game, Quaker Dale Prep Eagles only having six players. Northeast is going to sub a lot and look to push the pace throughout this game and kind of run up the scoreboard.
Really hurts when your team only has six people active on their roster. Because you play five people, that means only one person can get a break at a time.
Going to have the travel call on Phillips. Northeast gets the ball back now off another turnover for the Eagles. Emmett Page taking the ball up the court. Hands it off to Reinick. Reinick loses it. And dives for it. Great hustle play, but they're going to get him with the foul for diving into Phillips. Reinick just kind of fumbles the handoff there, and it's another turnover from Northeast. Both teams, quite a few turnovers here in the first half of this game.
Yeah, Quaker Dale has nine turnovers, and Northeast has three.
Northeast not turning over as much as we thought.
Kind of a slow-moving game.
Yeah, slow so far, which you wouldn't expect from a 41-14, but Northeast has kind of just been dominating this game at their own pace. Joel Ufili hands it off to Page. Page now coming up the court with the ball. Drives in, gets blocked, but Ufili with the rebound takes it up, and he gets fouled. Going to send him to the free throw line here.
This is where Ufili really needs to concentrate and make these free throws.
Foul going against Jaquez Harris. Ufili went 0 for 2 earlier, seeing if he can redeem himself. Gets the first one to fall. Looking here, see if we get the second free throw to drop. And that's up and in. He goes 2 for 2. Phillips taking the ball up the court. Looking to set up his man. Pass it down to Grimes. Grimes loses it. Page now with the ball driving, lobs it up, and Joel Ufili with the slam. Finally got some reactions out of this crowd tonight. Northeast been scoring a lot, but this game has kind of felt drained. But that was a good spark there for the Northeast as Phil the go-ahead layup on the drive.
You love to see that. You love to see that oop to your big man finishing with a big dunk.
Zach James off with the three-point shot. Here comes Barker with the ball. He's driving it in, kicks it out to Polanco. Now Grimes on the wing. Pass it over to Harris. Good step back. Off with the shot, however. Daniel Quay now taking the ball up the court. Caleb Reinick back to Quay. Quay takes it in and gets the and one layup. foul going to go against Kendall Grimes. That's his second of the half.
That was good awareness by Caleb to see Daniel cutting to the basket, get the pass, and quick it off, or dump it off real quick.
Daniel Quay with his first free throw of the night. See if he can convert the and one layup. And he does. 8:10 left to go here in the game. 48-16, the Northeast Hawks lead. Malik Griffin now up top, looking to set up the offense here. Pass it over to Harris on the wing. Northeast gonna trap. Down low to Griffin. Griffin passes up the shot over to Harris. Harris with the three. He's off by Kawasu now. Pump fake, drives on the court. Over to Page in the corner. Three-point shot up, and he's off.
If you're the Eagles, you would like to have that possession back. They saw they had Malik down low wide open, and he just couldn't handle the pass.
Now Northeast back on the fast break. Page takes it in. Easy layup for him. Phillips now looking to slow the pace down, see what he can do. Sending up his man over to Polanco. Northeast almost with the steal here. Down low to Harris, and Harris gets a wide open layup.
Blown defense by the Hawks there. They're looking to trap up top early, and they just lost Harrison.
Page now gets it over to Bikwaso. Up to Daniel, over to Joel. Caleb Reinick now with the ball. Down low to Bikwaso. Over to Joel. Joel pump fakes, and they're going to get him with the travel call. Seth Cota checking back in for the Northeast Hawks. Coach letting the Eagles know what play to run. Phillips at point. Setting up the offense here. They're going to get Emmett Page with the blocking call. A little too aggressive there on defense. Checking in, we have Junior Oscar for Emmett Page. 50-18, 6:32 left to go in the first half. Northeast out to a big lead. Looks like Northeast reached over the line. They're going to redo the inbound pass.
Northeast really just came out dominating today. It's only the first half, but I mean, this is a big hole that they dug themselves into for the Eagles.
Kind of a bad pass for Kevin Polanco. Tried to throw it up to Mike Barker, but the defense was right there. Junior Oscar now taking the ball up down the court. Gets a screen from Joel. Daniel Quay pump fakes. Step back three. And that's in. Northeast still killing it from three. Shooting 63.6%. That's a phenomenal three-point percentage. Junior with the steal. He's going to take it. Almost gets the and one layup. Daniel Quay wanted the ball, trying to get a dunk, but he'll support his teammate in the while he goes to the free throw line.
Junior really wanted that dunk as well. It was kind of a, either you take it or I take it. He thought he had the open lane.
Junior Oscar. About to shoot his first free throw here for the game. Ball. Ben Moxness checks in for Joel Ufili. We have Yusef Jasmine checking in for Caleb Reinick. Junior here looking to go 2-for-2 from the free throw line. And he gets the fall. Phillips now taking the ball up the court. Coming down a bit aggressive. Behind the back crossover. Down low to Barker. Barker with the slam of his own. That did not see that coming. Junior Oscar gets tangled up there with Phillips. They're going to tag Phillips with the reaching call.
He'll pick up his second. He'll have to come take a seat. Eagles don't want to risk him getting any more as he's leading the team right now with 8 points.
Checking in for him is Kendall Grimes. Daniel Quay coming off the screen. Down low to Moxis. Moxis out to Youssef. Youssef with the traveling call. I didn't see that, but maybe a little hop to his step when he caught the ball.
And his foot was on the line. You hate to see that. Player that doesn't see a lot of court time gets in. Has a wide open shot. Not only does he travel, but he steps on the line.
Going to get Daniel Quay with the reaching call. Northeast playing very aggressive on defense right now, trying to get their energy up. Looks like Luke Rollman's going to check in here. Daniel Quay is going to go take a seat. Harris now. Gets the screen from Grimes, goes the other way, takes it in, and he's off with the shot. Youssef now taking the ball up the court, over to Luke Rollman. Luke Rollman gets it down low and gets the layup to fall.
It's a good job by Youssef to see Rollman going straight to the hoop. Nice pass threading the needle, and then Rollman with the good finish.
Quakerdale steps over the line, inbounding the ball. It's going to be another turnover for them. They get the ball right back, though, stealing the inbound pass. Down low is Grimes, and he gets the layup to fall. Junior Oscar now calling the play. Ben Moxness up top, gives it to Seth Cotto on the wing, hands it off to Junior. Screen for Ben. Junior on the drive. Off with the layup. Tried to kiss it off the glass. Malik Griffin now pushing the ball up the court. Gets a three-point shot. And that falls for him. Junior Oscar now. Ben Moxness up top. Seth Cotto on the wing. Three-point shot from him. He's off. Luke Rollman with the rebound. He's off with the rebound. That's going to be out of bounds on Malik Griffin.
Northeast just couldn't get a shot right there to fall. They got a couple offensive boards and then just couldn't finish at the basket.
Seth Cotto inbounds it to Youssef. Youssef, three-point shot. He's off. Ben Moxon is fighting for the rebound, and that's going to go out on Harris. Phillips checks back in. Checking out is Kevin Polanco. Northeast had a lot of chances to score so far, trying to get a bucket to fall. Gets the junior. Junior wide open driving lane, and he gets the layup to fall. Looking for the and one, but doesn't get the call. Comes Malik Griffin down the court. He drives it in. Tries to kick it out, that's going to go off the hands of Northeast.
Northeast still kind of maintaining that lead. The Eagles have kind of come back a little bit, but Northeast still just edging ahead.
Barker with the drive, he's off the front of the rim. Gets the steal back, though, from Ben. Ben almost deflects it, tips it over to Junior Oscar. Junior Oscar taking the ball up the court now, drives it in, and he gets the foul call.
And then another foul on Grimes, picks up his third. Not what you want to see in the first half, picking up three fouls. That limits him only to the rest of the game.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for Northeast if he is in, or for Quakerdale if he is in foul trouble. He's definitely played a big part for them, and he's going to go take a seat until halftime more than likely. Checking back in is Kevin Polanco. Junior looking to get his second free throw to fall. And he does. Mike Barker running point here for the Eagles. Phillips in the corner, back up to Barker up top. Coming off the screen, step back. He's off. Northeast fumbles the rebound there, but Seth Cota comes up with it. Junior Oscar with the ball. Drives in and gets the layup. Nice little finesse on that shot.
He picks up his eighth point. Not really, we haven't seen a whole lot of offensive play out of Junior Oscar this year, but he's really coming up big this game.
Yeah, the offense for Northeast, they're doing a good job spreading the ball around. Right now on the court, we have 8, 8, 5, and 7, so a little bit of everybody scoring for Northeast tonight.
Junior Oscar, Seth Cota, Daniel Equate, and Joel Ufili all have 8 points for the Hawks, and Moses leads with 12 points.
Nice sharing the ball for Northeast. Luke Rollman looking for someone. Down low to Seth Cota. Back up to Yusef. Junior Oscar now with the ball. Back to Seth. Seth pump fakes. Gets the mid-range shot, but he's off. Ben tips it back out. Down to Luke Rollman. Luke Rollman gets the layup. Phillips now with the ball. Looking to set up the offense here. Over to Griffin on the wing. Griffin pump fakes. Shoots it. He's off. Rollman with the rebound. Oscar now taking the ball up. Over to Cota. Back to Junior. Down low to Ben Moxness. Ben Moxness with a hook shot. He's off. Quakerdale with the rebound. Barker takes it in. Nice finesse in the layup to get it to fall. Junior Oscar now slowly taking the ball up the court. He drives, takes it back out over to Luke Rollman. Luke Rollman down to Yusef. Yusef out to Junior. Junior with the three. He gets it to fall. Minute 10 left to go in the game. Northeast leading 68-30. Pretty much have control over this entire game.
Here you're going to see Anderson coming out of halftime, going to rotate a lot of people in, you know, that don't normally see the court. We see Yusef and Junior Oscar in there. Ben Moknis and Luke Rollman all see the court a lot, but it's nice to see them sub in a lot.
3-point shot for Mike Barker. Junior Oscar now taking the ball up the court. Rejects the screen, drives in, kicks it out to Yusef, over to Seth Cota, over to Luke Rollman. Nice swinging the ball around, and Ben Moxis gets the 3-point shot to fall. He's got 8 points on the night now. Phillips looking to get the last shot of the game here. He drives in, jumper. Banks it in from the free throw line. Ah, Ben Moxis with a bad turnover right before halftime. Northeast leading Quakerdale 71-37. We'll send it down to the court with the dancers. You're watching Hawk TV Sports.
Members of the dance team include Casey Stahlbaum from David City, Nebraska. Carter Lamb from Omaha, Nebraska. Ali Nowicki from Grand Island, Nebraska. Kennison Koontz from Stewart, Nebraska. Caitlin Steffensmeyer from Howells, Nebraska. And Kaylee Mulder from Rock Valley, Iowa. Your dance team is coached by Amanda Avidano.
Booty shake like an earthquake. There is no When I shake it in your face. Now don't you wanna tape a booty shaking on your tape? So show it to your boys and see the look on all their face. I move it to the left, move it to the right. Double time, I show them what they like. Look at it, slow motion freeze. Stop for the camera, paparazzi wanna see cheese. Hello, hey, how you doing? I shake it like this, now let me see if you could do it. Drop, 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 drop it on the one. Shake, 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 their faces all stunned. If you got it, then move it kinda fast. If the boys all gas, why they try to make a pass? Whistle while you work, go ahead, do your dirt, even if you like to flirt. Lift up your skirts, then turn them out. One leg up, go ahead, shake it out.
The Media Arts program is designed to train our students to prepare to create that content that they would see out in the world of media, from pure sound and sound effect that would include music, to cinematic looks, to creating news broadcasts and packaging news and broadcast information that people all over the world might look at.
Northeast Community College has a lot of advantages in our media arts program. When people try to do this on their own, they might be watching instructional videos online or reading books or just picking things up and trying them. And that's great. That's great to try and train yourself. But what happens is there's gaps in your knowledge. You find something that works, but you don't understand why it works. When you come to us, we will put all those gaps together. We will fill all of those gaps.
Before coming here, I didn't know a lot about sound. I mean, I'd run sound for my church, but I didn't know about the science behind it. And they completely deconstruct it and teach you the very, very basic physics of sound and how signal flow works and the electronics behind it. And they really work your way up. And it's hard, but it's very, very rewarding, and I definitely feel prepared for the industry.
When I was in school, the professors did a really good job of setting me up for knowing what to expect when I was in the working world. They did not lie to us, you know, it's not gonna be just roses all the time. You're gonna have to work some really long hours. You're gonna have to work really hard to find your jobs in the network.
There's so many different possibilities for learning, and anything that you want to learn, you can learn, and they teach you everything you need to learn in the industry. And so as long as you're willing to work hard, you're gonna learn a lot here, and there's the possibilities are just endless for knowledge.
A daily learning experience for a student here at Northeast would be hands-on simulation. What are you looking to do when you get your degree and you're out there in the industry? What can you expect as a student when you have that first job? What you're experiencing here as a student at Northeast is what you will be doing when you've got that first job. So it's really a hands-on simulation of what you're going to be experiencing in the job field.
One of the best things about Northeast's broadcasting department, I think, is the equipment we have right here in the department is exactly what you're going to see in the real world. From radio to TV, we have top-notch equipment. I'm in the radio business right now, and when I took that job, they have the exact same software as we have here in the school, and it made that transition very easy.
3, 2, 1.
I was into extremely confident in radio when I first started broadcasting here, but the labs really inspired confidence, and that was a good balance between learning about it and then going hands-on and making you comfortable with the two.
Being a non-traditional student here at Northeast has been seamless. A lot of the younger generation has treated me just as an average Joe, just another student here. It has been wonderful, and all the teachers and faculty have treated me in the exact same manner. I couldn't have picked a better place to come and fulfill my college dreams.
The most rewarding aspect of this job is to see the students succeed in what they're learning here. Through the labs, or maybe they picked up a part-time job while they're still going to school here, to see them grow and to see them succeed is the most rewarding thing ever.
It's rewarding to see someone go from being perhaps uncertain of themselves from either a technical or even a confidence standpoint, and to see them be able to start a project, plan a project, execute the project, and deliver the project. It's an amazing progression through 4 semesters to watch a student have that kind of growth and have that kind of experience and then gain that confidence so that you can throw anything at them and they go, okay, we can deal with that. That's probably the best.
The strength of the digital cinema program is partially just how individualized it can be, how much help you can get, on one specific project that you have, that the teachers will help, you can get, other students in the class to help, but it's also individual. You get to do the whole, I made this from concept, to content, just like that all by myself. So you just get that sense of pride of accomplishing something by yourself.
My favorite part about my experience in the digital cinema program is the diversity in the projects that we've been learning. I'd say my favorite project was when Miss Ensmith made us shoot a music video. It was pretty cool to see how what you can learn on your own and what you can do on your own within the first semester of shooting.
It's very rewarding and it's a lot of fun to see the students that graduate and go through our program. You can see when they get here, they're unsure of themselves, and as they go through our program, you can see their confidence build. And so right before they're going to be unleashed into the market, they're really operating at a pretty high level for a 2-year degree. They come out with all this knowledge and all these skills and abilities that make them highly valuable, and all they need is that one professional job, that one experience to put it with that, and sky's the limit.
I believe that the education that I've got here at Northeast is incredibly accurate to what the real world is going to be like out there in the film, digital cinema industry. Our professors that teach us these classes have experienced the exact same thing I'm going into. They know what it's like to work at a TV studio. They know what it's like to own their own business. Then they base, our classes, they base our projects on things that actually could come up or have come up in real life. So we're prepared for that.
What you see here is what you're going to see in the industry. The students have a pretty nice set to start with. They have most of the basic hand tools, wrenches and so forth, hammers and dollies, and the school provides the big equipment like the welders and the frame equipment. After they get through the first year with Tom, and Tom gives them a good basic foundation for a cooperative internship in the field, then when they come back to school, the first thing that we start is refinishing. They learn two tones, metallics, clear coats, blending. The second half of the second year, then we do frame and heavy collision. We do unibody diagnosis. We have a sonic measuring system, which is computer driven.
I can't believe what I can do now. I can do everything. And people always ask me what I do, and then I tell them what I do. Well, I do auto body, I paint cars.
They teach you so much stuff that you'll take with you. You might even be working with somebody and they're like,
Oh, I didn't know that.
I mean, it's not really the lab that makes the school, it's the instructors.
The instructors at Northeast are really nice. You almost go up to any one of them and ask them a question, they'll answer it.
If I could talk to each and every freshman before they enter the auto body program, I guess one of the things I'd tell them is to be dedicated. Get everything that you possibly can out of the program, and you'll learn a lot. The harder you try, the more you'll learn. And the second thing would have to be picky, because the pickier you are, the prouder you can be of your work, and being proud of our work and that feeling of satisfaction inside, that's why we do auto body.
I love working on cars.
I wake up every day and I want to come to class.
It's the most natural thing for
me. Welcome back here to the Cox Activity Center. I'm Landon Scheffler, joined alongside Noah Wilcox. We're looking at the verge of a blowout here. Hawks leading the Eagles 71-37. What have you seen from Northeast that's kind of propelled them into this lead, Noah?
Well, they started out very, very strong shooting from three. I don't think they missed until at least five shots were put up from behind the arc. But then their defense was just very, very good stopping this Eagles offense. And then their offense, on the other hand, was just a combined team effort of everybody sharing the points. Moses leads with 12 points. Junior Oscar is actually in second with 11. Luke Rollman has 9. And then Seth Cota, Daniel Aquay, Ben Mockness, and Joel Ufili have 8 points, and Emmett Page is falling behind with 7 points, so just a very good team effort today that we've seen.
Yeah, great team effort from Northeast, shooting 60% from the three-point line, which is phenomenal, 65.9 from the field goal, and like you said, a great team effort from them. They have 15 assists here in just the first half, just great team ball from Northeast. Moses and Emmett Page leading the team, both with 3 assists apiece. And Northeast also getting it from the free throw line. They had the first 2 missed free throws from Joel Ufili, but they haven't missed a free throw since, 8 of 10 on the night. Quakerdale's not having a terrible shooting night. They're shooting 27.8 from 3-point, which isn't great, but some nights you're just going to shoot worse than others, and 38.9. Turnovers have really been an issue for them. Northeast has gotten quite a few turnovers from them. 13 from Quakerdale, and it's hard to get a shot off when you're turning the ball over so much.
Definitely. You know, when you're on, you're on. But when you're off, you've got to shoot to get on. And Quakerdale just not having their numbers is really struggling when their people just can't hit it. They don't have anybody else to look for because this is all they have.
It'll be interesting to see what Northeast does here in the second half. If they continue to kind of push the ball up the court here and run quick offense, or if they kind of slow it down and see, just kind of work on their offensive plays, see what they can do. Quakerdale to start off here in the second half. Second half underway here in the Cox Activity Center. Phillips with the ball. Northeast looking aggressive here on defense. Harris up top, gives it over to Polanco. Over to Barker on the wing, drives it in, down to Phillips. Back to Barker, trying to get a shot up. Gets his own rebound, puts it up, and he's off. Now Northeast coming down the court. Page drives it in and gets the layup to fall. Very acrobatic. On the layup there.
If you were the Eagles coming out of that half, you would have really liked to see a point. They just got caught down low and didn't have quite the size advantage that Northeast has, and end up turning it over.
Yeah, Northeast definitely a lot taller than this Quakerdale Eagles team, so when they get it down low, they got to get it up fast, otherwise Northeast is going to close on them pretty quick. Barker inbounding the ball here, turns it over. Page now running it up the court. He gets a wide open layup. Northeast quick points early here in the second half, only a minute in. Harris up top, swings it over to Malik Griffin. Phillips on the drive, takes it into the teeth of the defense and gets the foul call against Joel.
Good penetration there by Phillips to drive right at the heart of Northeast defense, creating a foul. Just missed the and one shot by a little bit.
That's Joel Ufili's first foul here in the game. Phillips at the free throw line. Quakerdale now 5 for 5 for free throws today, so they have been taking advantage when they can get to the stripe, just haven't gotten there very often. And just like that, announcer's curse, he's off on that one. They're going to tag Daniel Quay with the travel call. That announcer's curse is a real thing.
Last week when Northeast was taking on Southeast, Daniel Quay really got caught with getting the rebound off of free throws, but then traveling right after. He got knocked down a couple times, which they call the travel. And then, as you saw right there, couldn't get away with it.
Northeast with some pressure defense here. Looks like they're kind of in a pressure 2-3. Trying defense, maybe something they can use later on in the season. Ball out of bounds against Quakerdale. Northeast now with the ball. Emmett Page running point. Seeing what he can do here on offense. Down low to Joel. Joel gets the spin off post move and he gets his shot to fall. Looks like Harris got a little banged up on that play. Phillips on the drive, takes it in. Off with the layup, Joel with the rebound. Emmett Page now with the ball. He drives it in, fakes the pass out, and gets the and one layup. Northeast starting the second half just like they started the first, very fast paced and quick on the scoring burst.
Northeast doing a really good job of, like you said, penetrating the defense of Quaker and just trying to create fouls, trying to get this team into foul trouble.
Emmett Page off with the free throw shot, but it looks like it's going to go off Malik Griffin. 18:07 left here in the game. Northeast leading 79-38. Seth Cota throws up to Daniel McQuay, back to Emmett Page. Page now gets the screen, and he turns it over to Harris. Harris now with the ball. Down low to Barker. Barker gets the layup. Good fast break offense there for the Eagles. Daniel Quay gives it over to Seth Cota. Page now up top. Gets the screen from Daniel over to Cota on the wing. Down low to Page, and he gets the foul call. Good offense from Northeast, just working around trying to find the best shot, and gets Emmett Page wide open. And that's going to be a technical, maybe a double technical. Harris and Page exchanging words down there on the court. Foul going to go against Harris. I think they might have called a double technical down there on the court. Harris gets first free throw to drop. Harris go take a seat on the bench. Kendall Grimes checks in.
Coach is not very pleased with that call. Just kind of disappointed in your players. You know, you only have 6 people, and then you can't be picking up technicals.
Page gets his free throw to fall. Eagles now on offense. Phillips drives it in, tries to get the layup to fall, but he can't. That is going to go off Northeast. Daniel tried to get the rebound and save it, but he could not. Phillips inbounding it over to Grimes. Phillips now with the drive, passes it over to Barker. Barker with the shot just off the rim. Griffin gets the rebound and he's off. Quay now with the ball, pushing it up the court. Over to Joel. Joel pump fakes and gets the layup. Good jump stop. Griffin with the ball. Step back three. He banks it in. Nice shot for Malik Griffin. Seth Coder now gives it back up to Emmett Page. Emmett Page dribbling around, gets the screen from McQuay. Back up to Joel. Joel sending a screen for Coder. Coder comes off the screen. Step back. He's off three-point shot.
Northeast really just looking to, you know, work their offenses, because coming up they have a very good game against North Iowa Area Community College, who's 4-2 on the season. You want to see your team run the offense, you know, practice that offense, practice your defense.
Northeast with the timeout. We will take one as well. You're watching Hawks basketball on the Hawks Sports Network.
I am a veteran. My victory was finding the strength to be a champion.
My victory is having a job I can be proud of.
At DAV, we help veterans get the benefits they've earned.
My victory was finishing my education.
My victory was getting help to put our lives back together.
DAV provides veterans with a lifetime of support.
My victory is being there for my family.
Help us support more victories for veterans. Go to DAV.org.
Hawks basketball here on the Hawks Sports Network. Northeast leading Quakerdale Prep 83-43, 16-17 left to go in the half. Northeast is kind of dominant this game. Like you said before the break, they have a great game coming up after this one. It'd be a good chance to work on your in-game offense and see if you can kind of get it polished up before you play against a really good team. Daniel Quay with the rebound, pushing the ball up the court now. Over to Joel Ufili. Joel takes it in and gets the layup. Northeast fast break offense has been phenomenal throughout this game.
We have not seen Moses Bicuasso score yet this half, but it's not like he really needs to.
Northeast tried to get the lob pass there, couldn't quite connect, takes it in. Barker, I'm going to tag Joel Ufili with the foul, sending Mike Barker to the free throw line. Mike Barker with the free throw shot. He gets it to fall. It's been a big part of the scoring offense here for the Quakerdale Eagles. Goes 2-for-2.
Yeah, the Eagles have two people in double-digit points right now. They've just been kind of not really helping this team stay in it, but not letting the lead go too big.
And it looks like Quakerdale kicked it out of bounds. Ben Moxness checks in for Northeast. Ben Mox in the corner, down low to Joel Ufili. Joel gives it to Page. Page with the wide open layup.
Page is really having a good day offensively, attacking the boards, getting the rebounds, and then attacking on the other side, attacking the basket, going right to the heart of the Eagles defense.
Barker fakes the handoff, step back three. He's off. Joel Ufili fights for the rebound, and we're going to have a jump ball here. I believe that should go for Northeast. Junior Oscar checking in. He's going to check in for Moses. Emmett Page now with the ball. Ben Mox is trying to set the screen. Page, wide open three, and just misses. Junior Oscar now with the ball. Back up to Emmett Page. Northeast gets the junior Oscar on the wing. Joel up top. Ben Moxis swings over to Coda. Lob to Joel Ufili. Great lob pass from junior Oscar and a great throw down from Joel. Might be the first lob pass I've seen since I've been at Northeast.
They just had one earlier in the first half.
From four Northeast. That fell?
Yeah, they did that. Joel dunked it.
Lob pass.
Yes.
Emmett Page with the ball. Ben Mox is now swinging it around. Ben Mox's hook shot. I don't remember that.
How?
I just don't.
Remember the crowd got into it and everything?
I remember Joel dunking it, but I don't remember it coming off a lob.
It was definitely off of a lob. It was on a fast break.
Joel almost loses the ball. Passed over to Seth Cota. Seth Cota taking it up. Gives to Page in the corner. Page, three-point shot. He's off again. Joel and Cota fighting for the rebound. Ben Moxis gets it. He gets the layup to fall. It looks like we're going to have a timeout on the court. We will take one as well. I will fix my memory. You're watching Hawk Sports here on the Hawk Sports Network.
It's about putting others first. It's doing your best at whatever you do. It's about being honest with yourself, with everything. It's all of these. It's more. It's commitment. This message is brought to you by the U.S. Air Force.
Welcome back here to the Cox Activity Center Northeast. Now leading 91-48, 13:37 left to go in this game. The score doesn't really show it. Northeast seems like they're going the same pace that they were in the first half, but they aren't scoring as much. I think they might be trying to run their offense a little bit more here.
They've taken 56 shots.
That's a lot of shots throughout the game.
And it's not even 10 minutes left in the second half.
Wakerdale 17-48 on the night. Northeast 36-56, shooting a great 64% from the field. Malik Griffin now with the ball. Trying to get over to Barker. Barker, 3-point shot with a hand in his face, but it looks like they're going to call it a two. His foot must have been on the line. Junior Oscar, Joel Ufili up top. Zach James on the wing, hands it off back to Oscar. Screen from Ufili. Oscar driving it in, gets the layup. Phillips now pushing it up to Barker. Barker, wide open three. He's off on that one. Great behind the back pass from Ufili. That looked nice. Seth Cota taking it in. And they're going to call him with a travel. I think he might have bounced it over his head on one of those dribbles. Rollman checking it in for Joel. Phillips now with the ball. Gives it over to Harris. Harris drives in, passes it down to Griffin. Griffin trapped down low. Gets it out though. Barker drives it in and his shot goes off the front of the rim. Junior Oscar now. Down low to Cota. Cota with the shot. He gets it to fall. Harris gives it up to Barker. Barker slowly taking the ball up the court.
Seth Cota having another good day. Shooting wise, he's got 10 already. Not as much as we normally see, but he's still helping out this offense.
Yeah, like we said earlier, the scoring has really been spread out for Northeast. Just on the court right now, we have 13, 10, and 10 and 9. Everybody seems to be scoring here for Northeast. Griffin now passes up to Barker. Barker drives it in. Almost gets the shot to go. Grimes misses as well. Barker with another rebound. Puts it up, and he's off. Eagles couldn't get a shot to fall right there. Barker with a steal, and now he gets the layup. Junior Oscar fighting off the pressure.
Northeast really needs to clean up that aspect of the game. They just had three offensive rebounds given to the Eagles and then turned it over to Barker for an easy bucket.
Junior Oscar throws it down to Luke Roman. Luke Roman gets bumped. Looks like they're going to tag Phillips with the foul, his third of the game.
The Eagles now have three players with three fouls. They really need to watch what they're doing defensively and offensively. You do not want to get into foul trouble.
Junior Oscar up top gives it to Seth Cota on the wing. Seth Cota setting up his man with the three, and he splashes it. Malik Griffin now takes the ball up the court. Drives it in. The foul is going to be on the floor. Hand check against Ben Moxness. His first foul of the game. Barker shot off the inbound. They're going to tag Moxness with another foul. Back-to-back fouls for Ben Moxness. Looks like Daniel Quay might come in for him.
Two back-to-back fouls, not what you want to see when you're just trying to run out the clock a little bit and pull away with this game.
Yeah, I never want to foul a guy on a three-point shot especially. Coaches do not like that. It's a quick ticket to the bench if you foul a guy on a three-point shot. I know from personal experience in high school, coaches are not happy when you foul three-point shots. Free throw falls for Barker. Moxness heading to the bench. Coming in is Daniel LeQuay. Gets the second free throw, third free throw to fall. Junior Oscar now taking the ball up the court. Seth Cota now. Swings it over Daniel Clay. Junior Oscar, three-point shot. He's off. Zach James almost with the tip-in. And it's going to be a foul call against Seth Cota. Sixth foul of the half for Northeast. Griffin up top. Over to Barker on the wing. Barker setting up his man. Tries to get step back three. Grimes right there. Phillips on the wing. He drives. Over to Grimes in the corner. Pump fake. Step back. Off with the three-point shot. Daniel Quay with the rebound. Swings it over to Seth Cota on the wing. Pump fakes. Takes it back out. Junior on the cut. Great layup. Junior during warm-ups, I swear, he does the craziest layups. This guy can really score it from anywhere near the basket.
That was a good little finesse move, little up and under, and then up again.
Northeast now in triple digits, leading 100-54 and 940 left in the game. Barker drives it in, floater. Just ekes off the rim, almost loses the rebound, Daniel Quay, but he gets it finally. Northeast has numbers here. Luke Roman drives it in. He's off. Daniel Quay almost with the tip in, but he's off as well. Now we have Griffin taking the ball up. Phillips pump fakes, drives it in. Off with the layup, and that's going to go. Looks like it might have been off Northeast, but they're going to say against Quakerdale. Daniel Quay here. Pass up to Seth Cota.
Northeast just looking to use all 30 seconds of their shot clock. You know, just kind of wear this game down a little bit.
Zach James on the wing. Gets a screen from Daniel. Drives it in. Tries to pass it down to Daniel, but gets shot. Her pass gets blocked. Luke Roman takes it in, gets blocked. Northeast struggling a bit on offense here the past few drives. Barker, another floater. He's off again. Junior Oscar taking the ball up the court. He's got a driving lane, gives it over to Luke Roman. Luke Roman with the layup.
Good job there by junior Oscar, pushing the ball up the court, finding Roman wide open down low on the block.
We're going to have a timeout for Quakerdale. We're going to take one as well. You're watching Hawk Sports on the Hawk Sports Network. Whatever it takes, because I love the adrenaline in my veins. I do whatever it takes, because I love how it feels when I break the chains. Whatever it takes, yeah, take me to the top. I'm ready for whatever it takes, because I love the adrenaline in my veins. I do what it takes. Welcome back to the Cox Activity Center here at Northeast Community College. Your Hawks are leading 102-54, 8:27 left in the game. Northeast really dominated this game throughout, just from beginning to end. Looking to close it out here. Northeast is playing a great game, and pretty much everybody scoring for Northeast. Very few people on the team have not scored yet.
They've done a really good job of just spreading the ball out on the floor, you know, finding those open looks, getting that extra pass, gauging that shot, making sure it goes in.
Yeah, Northeast now up to 21 assists, really doing a good job sharing the ball and finding the best shot possible. Griffin. Off of the shot. I don't know why it didn't sound right in my head. Caleb with the ball. Shoots it from three. He's off. Luke Rollman gets the rebound, but he loses it. Malik now taking the ball up the court. Grimes spin move off with the floater. Junior Oscar now gives it over to Daniel Quay on the wing. Zach James in the corner, wide open. He's off. Luke Rollman going to tag him with a push in the back. His first foul of the game. And do we have one-on-ones here?
Yeah.
We do have one-on-ones. It's going to send Malik Griffin to the line. He's off with his first free throw. Junior Oscar now looking to set up the offense. Gets a screen from Daniel, and they're going to get Phillips with the hand check. His fourth foul of the game. One more and he's going to have to take a seat. Looks like he might take a seat right now. Yep, Phillips checking out. Mike Barker checking in. Caleb Renick inbounding the ball.
Really hurts for the Eagles right there, having your second team leading scorer go down with four fouls. He has to take a break. You don't want him. You want to use him if you have to.
Luke Roman gets fouled on the post move. Going to get Kendall Grimes with that. That's his fourth foul now. And Phillips coming back in.
If you're Northeast, you did your job right. You got two of their main players into foul trouble, and then their leading scorer only has one, but another big part of their offense has three fouls and a technical. So if you're Northeast, you've done a really good job of that. But if you're the Eagles, you kind of want to stay back a little bit on fouls as much as you can.
Grimes now with his fourth, taking a seat. Malik Griffin taking the ball up the court. Gives it over to Polanco up top. Over to Harris. And they're going to tag Junior Oscar with the foul. Harris going to head to the free throw line here for the Eagles. See what he can do at the free throw line. Gets the first one to fall. They're going to go 2 for 2 here. off on the second. Daniel Quay with the rebound, gives it over to Junior Oscar. Daniel up top, James on the wing, hands it over to Oscar. Oscar coming off the screen. Getting double teamed, pass it over to Daniel. Daniel crossover over to Junior. Junior with the shot, he's off. Zach James fights for the rebound, gives it up to Daniel. Caleb gets fouled on the shot. They're going to call a blocking foul. That's going to go against Griffin. That's his first foul of the game. And now Northeast in the bonus. They're going to shoot free throws for the foul shot, but any fouls from here on out will send them to the free throw line as well. .650 left to go in the game. Northeast leading 103-55. Now 104-55 off the free throw.
It's a good win for the Hawks today. They really came out firing on all cylinders. Tried a bunch of new things on offense. It kind of paid off for them.
Phillips looking to set up his defender. Gives it over to Griffin in the corner. He's off. Daniel with the rebound. Taking the ball up the court. Kicks it out to Caleb. Caleb far back to the three-point line.
That's good job by Daniel and timing and Daniel Aquay to really read the defense, find Caleb down there in the corner and hit that three.
That three was from deep. He was almost out of bounds. Daniel Aquay, Euro step. He gets fouled. It's going to go against Kevin Polanco. Daniel Quay with the free throw shots. Get this first one to fall. Northeast now shooting 70% from the free throw line. Great night for them. Ben Mocknis going to check in for Daniel if he makes his free throw shot. And if he does,
very good day from Daniel Aquay for the Hawks. He has 10 points. Coach Anderson wants him to take a little break.
Phillips comes off the screen from Griffin. Passes it over to Barker. Barker passes over to Harris. Harris with the drive. And he gets it after he kisses off the glass. Junior Oscar taking the ball up the court for Northeast.
Got a mismatch down low with Luke Roman and Barker, but Roman cannot handle the ball.
Barker now with the ball. Step back from Phillips. He gets it to fall. Good three-point shot from Phillips. Junior Oscar with the ball now. Gives it to James on the wing. Pass it up to Roman up top. Ben Mocknis swings it over to Caleb. And we're going to get illegal pick against Junior Oscar. Happened away from the ball. It's his third foul on the night.
Just didn't get his feet set. Kept walking away with the defender, creating the foul.
Phillips walking the ball up the court here. Gets the handoff from Griffin, but he loses it. Gets it back. Loses it again. Caleb with some great defense. Oscar now taking the ball up the court. Gives it to Mocknis. Mocknis, great catch. And Luke Roman powers it through the tough defense. Gets an and one layup. Roman's having a good game as well. Northeast lead now up 111-60. 4:40 left to go in the game.
One thing that you really like to see from your team is having eight players in double-digit points.
Three-point shot from Griffin. He's off. Ben swings it over to Zach James. Zach James, three-point shot. off, but Ben with the rebound gets blocked, however, from Barker. Phillips now taking it in. Takes it in on the teeth of defense, couldn't get it to fall. Oscar now with the ball. Looking to work the offense here. Roman up top. Zach James in the corner. And another illegal pick called against Northeast. This one's going to go against Caleb Renick. Timeout here on the court. We will take one as well. You're watching Hawks basketball here on the Hawks Sports Network.
We've all seen stories of conflict that ended with peace. We've seen stories of hunger end in abundance. We see stories of fear, despair, and poverty, but they can end with courage, hope, and love. With you. Be a part of writing a story that's greater than poverty. Learn how at worldvision.org.
Northeast basketball here at the Cox Activity Center. 4 minutes left to go in this game. Northeast with a big lead, 111-260 over the Quakerdale Prep Eagles. Both teams up there in foul trouble, so this might be a long 4 minutes. If I was Northeast, I'd look to kind of run down the clock here a little bit, see if you can send these players home with the win.
Yup. Northeast just really needs to work on their offense right here, work on fundamental defense. This is a big fundamentals part of the game right here.
Griffin now with the ball. Setting up the offense here for the Eagles. Pass over to Kevin on the wing. He drives it in. No shot, foul on the ground. That's going to go against Caleb Rionic. Going to send him to the free throw line regardless. He gets two here. On the first shot, he's off. Gets a second free throw to fall. Rionic to rebound. Gets Junior Oscar. Taking the ball up the court. Over to Caleb. Caleb gives it to Zach James on the wing. Junior with the ball. Screen from Rionic. Looks like he's called for the double screen here. Griffin with the aggressive D. Caleb with the three-point shot. He's off. James gets the rebound, puts it up. And he gets the layup. Great hustle from James.
Nice job picking up his first points of the season for Zach James.
Luke Roman now on defense. Phillips up top. Kicks it out to Harris. Harris three-point shot. He's off. Luke Roman with the rebound gets to Zach James. Zach James taking it up over to Junior Oscar. He's looking to slow it down here, run some offense. Zach James up top. Caleb on the wing. Hands it off to Junior Oscar. Down low to Luke. Luke looking to do work in the post, and he does. Gets the easy layup.
He picks up his 15th point. 15th point of the match.
Crossover three from Barker. He's off, but Northeast barely gets the rebound. Youssef now taking the ball up the court. Gives it to Luke Rollman. Foul against Kevin Polanco. Grabs Rollman's arm on the layup. His third of the day. Luke Roman hits his first free throw. Grimes checking in for the Eagles. Kevin Polanco going to go take a seat.
Rollman is having himself a night here in the Cox Activity Center. He is just 1 point away from tying the leading score for the Hawks.
It's going to go off northeast. Quaker de la Ball.
Rollman actually has a double-double right now, 11 rebounds and 16 points. And then Daniel Aquay also has a double-double with 13 rebounds and 10 points.
Phillips, pass over to Griffin on the wing. Griffin with the shot, and he gets it to fall.
Bangarang.
Junior Oscar now with the ball. He's over to Reinick. Reinick passes to Youssef. Youssef pump fakes it down low. Zach James swings over to Junior. Junior, Northeast looking to get it down low to Luke. Crossover from Youssef. He's off. Phillips taking the ball up the court. Drives it in. Floater. He's off. Caleb Reinick gets another great steal. Pass over to Youssef. Youssef down to Luke Rollman. Luke Rollman gets the easy layup.
Those 2 points, Luke Rollman is tonight's leading scorer.
105 left in the game. Northeast leading 118-64. Phillips' three-point shot. He's off. Zach James now with the ball. Gives it to the Junior. Junior three-point shot. He's off. Caleb with the rebound. Gets blocked from behind. Zach James with the rebound. Kicks out to Youssef. Youssef drives in. Crossover behind the back. Loses it for a second. Gets it back. James gives it over to Oscar. Oscar now slowing it down, trying to run the offense here. Maybe work the shot clock. Zach James with the ball. Caleb Reinick wide open down low. Gets the easy go-ahead layup. Shot clock and game clock pretty much in sync here. And Quakerdale might run offense here. Looks like they might just dribble it out as well. Trying to get the last shot of the game. It's a good win for Northeast. High scoring. One turnover. Here comes Luke Rollman, and he gets it done. The crowd was loving that. Get him with Quakerdale, hold on to the ball, and Northeast gets an extra 2 points at the end of the game. Half court shot. He's off. Northeast with the win, 122-64 over the Quakerdale Prep Eagles. We'll be right back with the post-game show here on Hawks Sports Network.
My name is Blake. I received a heart transplant when I was 2 weeks old. I play defense for the Red Hot Tornadoes. Sometimes my heart starts pounding like faster and faster as I go. I know I have someone else's heart inside me. It makes me feel happy because someone was generous enough to give me a second chance to live.
This gift of life was made possible by an organ donor. Imagine what you could make possible. Sign up as an organ, eye, and tissue donor. Go to organdonor.gov.
Post-game show, I'm Landon Scheffler alongside Noah Wilcox. Northeast with the win, 122-64. What'd you like most from that win for Northeast?
Just the team play aspect that Northeast brought to the table. They came out shooting really good, playing great defense, and then on the offensive side, they made it work for the team.
Yeah, Northeast with 25 assists. They got up 82 shots in this game and shot 58.5%. Just great offense all around. Everybody on the team with a point except for Youssef. Luke Rollman